Kachenje area for almost 30 minutes now, but we don't seem to be finding the location where the cadres are actually based right now. As you can see, the police officers seem to be lost. We seem to be don't seem to have the grip of where to find the cadres. So right now we seem to be changing the direction. We're going a different direction altogether with the hope of finding the cadres who are holding on to the movie TV equipment and also who actually beat movie TV reporters earlier in the day and also confiscated the equipment. This is the army that is geared with the tear gas canisters and also AK assault rifles ready to move in and quell the situation. We're in the middle of Nakachenje area and the police officers are trying to locate the cadres. As you can see, they seem to be fully geared, and also as part of the entourage is MMD Lusaka Province Vice Youth Chairperson Henry Mutonga. We are here in Nakachenje. Don't seem to see where the cadres are. As you can see there, and these are the bushes where the cadres actually emerged from earlier in the day and beat up a movie TV news crew. Some cadres have been spotted and the police officers are actually sprinting right now. We are moving in. We seem to be closing up on the cadres. The rest, the battle still continues. We are still forging ahead together with the police officers. Well, they've been spotted. We can actually see them from here. They are running away. The police officers have also put up their speed. We're very optimistic to catch them. This is a good sign. Already, one has been apprehended. And this is the guy who helped in identifying his colleagues. Others are actually running at a distance there. Some of the cadres at a distance, they're busy running away. But the police officers are equally optimistic. Oh, it's been a marathon runner. We've been running up and down with the police, trying to find the cadres who actually beat up movie TV reporters earlier in the day and also confiscated equipment. We can see some in far-flung areas, but well, for now this is as far as my energy could take me, but I'll still continue running and ensuring that whatever the police officers are actually doing on the ground, we are on top of the game. We can actually see a group of cadres gathered on a hill at some place by the police officers, because as of now others had gone in directions. The crew that we have right now seems to be outnumbered, so they can't move in just like that. They have to wait for reinforcement. So far about 8 of them have been cut and they've been forced to lie down as the police officers are conducting their drill. And the women are also being fished from the house. They were all hiding. Finally, after almost an hour pursuing these cadres, the officers have managed to actually get hold of the suspects. More than 20 suspects have actually been apprehended. Some are said to have come here to come and buy plots. Some still have to start the investigations. For this reason, even those that were praying earlier, the prayers don't seem to have been answered. They're still taken in for questioning. And it is from this group that police officers are expected to gather enough evidence regarding what transpired in the morning, where movie TV personnel were beaten up and where the equipment that was stolen in the morning is being held.
I would say most of these faces are new faces, but the only cadre whom I can identify as for now is this my young man here, is my cadre. And if anything, I would take this opportunity to say that I condemn what has happened today, because there was no need of the suspected, if they were MMD or any other group, trying to harass our noble journalists. That's very bad.
If we don't feel protected, how are we going to report, and how are we going to inform the nation? For me, it's very disheartening, Brian. I failed to sit in the office. I had to come and see for myself. You can look at the attire. Definitely, we've had to travel and walk kilometers and kilometers in pursuit of not only our camera, but to hear the stories. For me, what is more important is not the equipment, but the safety and the lives of our people. You've seen the gruesome pictures of how our crew has been injured, of how our reporters have been terribly beaten. And I continue insisting that if the MMD, that is the party in government, are listening, I'm here with one of the officials who's confirmed that some of their cadres are here. All the people that we've spoken to here, Bran, are saying that the people who go terrorizing people in their homes claim to be MMD cadres. The reporters that came here said these people chant the slogan of Bomani Boma. So what? Where are these people getting the power from? This is the question we're asking. And we're only appealing to government through the relevant authorities. I've been speaking to Dr. Solomon Jerry, who's Director of Operations under the Zambia Police Service. He's managed to speak to his team of officers at Matero who've come here with us. But we wonder what is going to happen to these people once we leave, once the officers don't give them protection. We've been told of stories only last week that people here were harassed, the police in this area, no. So as a media fraternity, we are really saddened by this. We are appalled by what is going on here, especially that it is being perpetrated by people who are calling themselves cadres from the ruling party.
We went for an assignment in Lusaka West, somewhere around, at around 12 hours. When I was filming, because I was the camera person there, so when I was filming, we just saw the mob of cadres coming. So by the time, I was filming them when they are coming. So when they wanted to see what I was filming, we started pushing each other. They started fighting. And then later, because they overpowered me, they were about 12 guys surrounding me. So they started beating me up using stones, iron bars, some punching me, some kicking me, sticks. Then later on, they pushed me in a foundation. That's how they got the camera. Then later on, they just continued beating me, even if though they got the camera from me.
To Lusaka West to film an assignment. So when we reached there around 12 hours, we were taken to a farm which has been demarcated by some cadres. So around 12:10, somewhere there, we just saw a group of people coming, a group of cadres, about 100 plus.
And were beaten badly. And then for me, they tried to rape me the whole time. And we started running back to the car, and they threatened to burn us alive if they.
I'm joined by Mr. Zambia Chairman. We just like to get a response from him following the harassments of journalists, looking at the fact that four of Mobi TV journalists have been assaulted and the camera has been grabbed. Mr. Skazwe, we'd just like to find out what could be your response in this case in point, looking at the fact that journalists in the country have been harassed.
As Mr. Zambia, we are deeply disturbed by this tale of events, because a violation of media rights of the highest class has been committed. At this particular point, we would like to see to it that all those cadres who are involved are brought to book, and I would like to thank the Zambia police for moving in swiftly and arresting some of the cadres. We would like to call upon the MMD in particular, because it has come to our attention that those cadres involved are from the MMD, to ensure that their cadres exercise maximum restraint.
Our reporters have been harassed and the camera has been confiscated. What would be your comment on that?
Our reaction to that is that any form of violence against journalists is intolerable. and especially in a non-political engagement that you had where you are covering illegal allocation of land, people must be able to tolerate journalists to do their work. So the administration, especially the party in government, must do its best to ensure that they restrain their cadres from attacking journalists. We wish to take this opportunity to ask all party leaders to commit to a peaceful and non-violence campaign, especially towards the media in this context. But on this particular one, we are calling on the police to move swiftly so that they can arrest those cadres, and this could serve as an example against others. It's dangerous in a political year like this one, and we are almost in the campaign period.
I would like to condemn in the most serious manner the act of violence, not only on the journalists, by the double MD, the MMD, this afternoon. The MMD have shown high levels of intolerance from people who carry stories as they ought to be. The MMD have demonstrated today the renaissance of what we saw in Chilanga against political force. The MMD have also demonstrated their barbarian tendencies, as we saw in Mufumwe. It is indeed a shame. The president of MMD, Mr. Rupia Banda, must come out very, very clear, because his chairman, as if we were all children, came and said he only recognized one cadre this afternoon from MMD, and that the rest were just spontaneous people. We need to protect this country. This country requires protection. And as you go to vote, fellow Zambians, you must know that as you vote for any of these two parties, you are voting for self-destruction.